الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. وإذ ابتلى إبراهام ربه بكلمات فأتمهن قال إني جاعلك للناس إماما قال ومن ذريتي قال لا ينال عهدي الظالمين وإذ جعلنا البيت مثابة للناس وأمنا واتخذوا من مقام إبراهام مصلى وعهدنا إلى إبراهام وإسماعيل أن طهرا بيتي للطائفين والعاكفين والركع السجود وإذ قال إبراهام رب اجعل هذا بلدا آمنا وارزق أهله من الثمرات من آمن منهم بالله واليوم الآخر قال ومن كفر فأمتعه قليلا ثم أضطره إلى عذاب النار وبئس المصير وإذ يرفع إبراهام القواعد من البيت وإسماعيل ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم ربنا واجعلنا مسلمين لك ومن ذريتنا أمة مسلمة لك وأرنا مناسكنا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم ربنا وابعث فيهم رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياتك ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة ويزكيهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم ومن يرغب عن ملة إبراهام إلا من سفه نفسه ولقد اصطفيناه في الدنيا وإنه في الآخرة لمن الصالحين إذ قال له ربه أسلم قال أسلمت لرب العالمين الله أكبر
الله أكبر
سمع الله لمن حمده
ربنا ولك الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، ملك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. إذ قال له ربه أسلم، قال أسلمت لرب العالمين. وأوصى بها إبراهام بنيه ويعقوب: يا بني إن الله اصطفى لكم الدين فلا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أم كنتم شهداء إذ حضر يعقوب الموت إذ قال لبنيه ما تعبدون من بعدي قالوا نعبد إلهك وإله آبائك إبراهام وإسماعيل وإسحاق إلها واحدا ونحن له مسلمون. تلك أمة قد خلت، لها ما كسبت ولكم ما كسبتم، ولا تسألون عما كانوا يعملون. الله أكبر،
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا ولك الحمد. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله الذي نشر بقدرته البشر وصرف بحكمته وقدرته وابتعث محمداً إلى كافة الأنام فأحل وحرم وأحل وأباح وحذر، لا يغيب عن بصره وسمعه دبيب النمل في الليل إذا سرى، يعلم السر وأخفى ويسمع أنين المضطر إذا دعا ويرى، لا يعزب عن علمه مثقال ذرة في الأرض ولا في السماء.
Praise and thanks are due unto Allah, Allah who created human being and made us to live our livelihood on this earth. It is Allah who uses His wisdom and kind judgment to distribute among His creation their needs and benefit. Allah has the ability and the knowledge to see and hear the little ants in a darker night when she is making movement. It is Allah who is aware of all secrets, and it is Allah who is aware of all of our hidden deeds. It is Allah who allows us to perform deeds that He has recommended and commanded us to do. It is Allah who has forbidden us from the engagement into deeds and acts that He has commanded us to stay away from. And it is Allah who exercises flexibility on us as mercy.
اصطفى آدم ثم تاب عليه وهدى.
Fellow slaves of Allah, it is Allah the Almighty who chose Prophet Adam, may Allah be pleased with him, to be the father of the humankind, because Prophet Adam passed the boundary and the limit that Allah has set for him. Due to Allah's mercy on us, Allah taught Prophet Adam in words and deed how to repent sincerely. And after the sincere repentance, Allah the Almighty guided our father Adam.
وَابْتَعَثَ نُوحًا فَبَنَى الْفُلْكَ وَسَرَى.
It is Allah who sent Prophet Nuh, peace be unto him, to his people, that he lived among them for years, propagating the message of Allah. They only grew in rejections except for few. Then Allah commanded him to build the ark on the top of a mountain. It was by the grace and the ability of Allah that he sailed the ark with Prophet Nuh and those who believe in him.
وَنَجَّ الْخَلِيلَ مِنَ النَّارِ فَصَارَ حَرُّهَا بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا.
It is Allah the Almighty who saved and protected his friend Prophet Ibrahim, peace be unto him, when he was placed in a burning fire as a way of punishment and torture by those who disbelieve in Allah from among his people. Allah made the blazing fire to be an air conditioning for Prophet Ibrahim and security.
ثُمَّ ابْتَلَاهُ بِذَبْحِ ابْنِهِ فَأَدْهَشَ وَبِبَصَرِهِ فَفَدَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ.
Fellow slaves of Allah, it is Allah the Almighty who tested the faith of Prophet Ibrahim, peace be unto him, to slaughter his only son. Prophet Ibrahim became confused. This is my only son that I've asked for after years. Now I'm commanded by Allah to slaughter my son. Because of the mercy and endowment of Allah, when he attempted to do so because of the fear of Allah and the love of Allah, Allah substituted the sons of Prophet Ibrahim with an animal to be slaughtered for the sake of the Almighty Allah.
عباد الله لم يزل كثير من الناس يلهثون ويلعبون ويتعبون ويسعون فمنهم من يسعى لجمع المال من جميع القنوات ومنهم من يلهث في بهيمية خلف الشهوات ومنهم من يهرور وراء الشهرة والجاه والسلطان في سباب قد أمضى رحلاته.
Fellow slaves of Allah, having listened to what you have just been told, we've learned and understood this very well. However, there are still many of us who are still dancing, playing, engaging into tireless efforts, striving and struggling only to achieve their selfish desires through means, through their energy, making every effort. But indeed, the time has passed for all of those things. And there are others who making all of the effort, striving from day and night only to get wealth, only to accumulate money from any means possible, whether it's good or bad, they just want to have it, as we can see today, which is glaring in our time. There are also others who are striving, who are struggling, who are manipulating only to be recognized, only to get title, only to get respect and honor so that people can see them. But indeed, all of these tireless efforts, all of these wrong methods, the time has passed.
وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَعْدُوا وَرَاءَ الْأَمَانِ وَالْأَحْلَامِ يَسْبَحُ مِنْ غَيْرِ مَا وَيَطِيرُ مِنْ غَيْرِ جَنَاحِ.
Fellow slaves of Allah, there are others who behave none other than an animal only to satisfy their selfish desires. And there are others who are living in an imaginary state. All they do is to imagine, well, I will be rich, I will be president, I will be this. And you're not making any effort. Now, the status of that person who having daydream is like one who feel or think that he is swimming, but he's not in the water. Now, how can you swim when you're not in the water? And then there are others who also making other efforts, thinking that maybe he or she will fly, but he has no wing.
عباد الله ضياع أعمار نفيسة في أغراض خسيسة أما إنك والله لو سألتهم جميعا من وراء ذلك السعي والطلب ماذا تريدون تتعبون هكذا لا أجابوك بقولهم.
Fellow slaves of Allah, life as a treasure that Allah has bestowed upon us. Allah has given us the opportunity and privilege to live as a human being. Our life is so important, but however, people are using this important life only to achieve useless things, useless outcome. And when you should ask them, all of this struggle, all of this striving, all of the difficulties that you are going through, what is it you want? What is it you want to achieve? What is going to bring you, and what will be the answer and the outcome? Now, they will give you their own words as answer.
La ajabuk al-hayat al-tayyibata nureed. La ilaha illallah. Araduha fa-akhta'u tariqaha.
Fellow slaves of Allah, don't be surprised to hear when they will respond to your question by saying, all of what that I'm doing, what I want at the end of the day, I want to have a beautiful life. I want to have a comfortable life. I want to have a decent life. This is surprising. And now let us bear in mind that there's no God except Allah. We must accept this as a reality. Those people, those individuals, they have desired something for themselves, but they use the wrong method.
وَكَانُوا كَمَنْ تَغَدَّى فِي الْمَنَامِ.
Now, they happen to be like the one who in his dream felt that he had lunch or meal. But when you wake up, your stomach stays empty. So you are living in the state of dream, but not reality.
أَقُولُ لَكَ عَبْدَ اللَّهِ مَهْلًا مَهْلًا وَاللَّهِ لَا يُسْعِدُ النَّفْسِ وَلَا يُزَكِّيهَا وَلَا يُطَهِّرُهَا وَلَا يَذْهَبُ هَمُّهَا وَغَمَّهَا وَقَلَقَهَا إِلَّا الْإِيمَانُ بِاللَّهِ جَلَّ جَلَالُهُ.
Fellow slaves of Allah, if you want to know the method and the solution to your problem, you can never become successful. You can never become strengthened and purified. And there's no way your worries, your difficulties, your problem will escape from you, will go away, except for one thing, and that is the sincere belief in the Almighty Allah.
Abdullah, طيب الحياة في آية واحدة من كتاب الله. قال تعالى: من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة. هذا هو الحياة الطيبة، إنها في عمل صالح لا غير.
Fellow slaves of Allah, in order to live a beautiful life, in order to live a comfortable life, in order to live a decent life, it is only mentioned in one verse in the Holy Quran. Now listen to the words of Allah. Allah said, those men and women who believe in Allah and engage into deed sincerely for the sake of Allah, which is good deed, Allah said, those men and women, I will reward them. And not only that, Allah said, I will give them a beautiful life that they will live. So, to attain beautiful life, to attain comfort, to attain stability, can only be when you engage into good work and believe in Allah sincerely. That is your answer.
عباد الله، من خلال تربية المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم لهذه الأمة على عمل صالح الذي يدرك صاحبها إلى حياة طيبة، تربى صحابته الكرام، فكان كل صحابي أمة وحده، فما من صحابي إلا وله صفة خاص وموقف خاص في هذا الدين استشهر به وعلم به ورفع به.
Fellow slaves of Allah, because of the decent modeling, the decent conduct and behavior, as well as the characteristics of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, he uses his discipline and training to strengthen the unity, to strengthen the bond among his companions. And he made all of them to be one and the same, which we have failed in our community, which we have failed in our home, in our masjid. Now what happened? The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, he ensured that every companion of his will have a specific assignment and responsibility that you will carry on. And they will be known for that. So it's not any overlapping of function. Everybody want to do the same thing simply because you don't have respect for the intelligence of the next man.
فَأَمَّا زَيْد فَكَانَ يَجْمَعُ الْقُرْآنِ وَأَمَّا عُمَرْ فَكَانَ يُدَوِّنُ الْأَحَادِيثِ.
Now, Zayd, may Allah be pleased with him, his responsibility was to compile the Quran. When a verse is revealed, his assignment to serve as a compiling clerk. Now, the sons of Umar, his responsibility was to ensure that he memorizes all of the hadiths of the Holy Prophet. So he served as the memory bank. So he had nothing to do with the compilation of the Quran, but to memorize the hadiths.
وَأَمَّا ابْنُ عَبَّاسٍ فَكَانَ يَخْرُجُ إِلَى الْأَسْوَاقِ لِيُسَلِّمَ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَيُذَكِّرُهُمْ بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.
Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, his assignment and responsibility was to reach out, to be the officer who will reach out in the community. He will go to the marketplaces, he will greet the people, he will interact with them, he will remind them of Allah's word and how to behave as Muslim. But for us, as human beings, we Muslim today, we all want to remain in the same place to do one assignment. That's why I bring a conflict and misunderstanding.
وَأَمَّا خَالِدَ بْنَ الْوَلِيدِ فَقَدْ احْتُبِسَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ فِي حَيَاتِهِ لِلَّهِ دِرْعُهُ مَتَاعُهُ مَالُهُ كُلُّهَا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ.
Khalid bin Walid, dear slaves of Allah, he put at the disposal of the Almighty Allah everything that he owned, his money, himself, his property, for the sake of Allah. So that was his assignment. He was a man who was ever ready to take on any difficult assignment.
Abdullah, أقول لك مرة ثانية مهلا مهلا فإن خالد والصحابة الكرام جعلوا الدنيا تحت قدميهم وأنت جعلت الدنيا همك وقد ذهب وانتهى أمر الدنيا.
Fellow slaves of Allah, let me remind you once again to be calm and take time as to how you manage and deal with issue. Why? Because Khalid and other faithful companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be unto him, they look at the world and its material. They place it under their feet. It was never a major worry for them. But today, you and I, our concern, our worry, our objective is to what can I get out of life? I want a new car. I want a new house. I want this. I want that. That is our worry. But we are not even concerned about Islamic responsibility as Muslims. That's what makes it difficult for us.
Khalid, ma Khalid. صحابي جليل غزا في أيام المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم ولم يزل غازيا يوم مات المصطفى وولي غيره بالخلافة فغزا أكثر من 100 غزوة بدأها بغزوة مؤتة أول غزوة بدأ به خالد كان بعد إسلامه بثلاثة أشهر فأنت ولدت في الإسلام وعشت في الإسلام وكنت فيها منذ طفولة أنعومك أنت فيها منذ 30 سنة وفيها منذ 40 سنة وفيها منذ 50 سنة ماذا قدمت لدين الله فاسأل نفسك هذا السؤال وانصف نفسك فيها.
Fellow slaves of Allah, who is Khalid bin Walid? Khalid bin Walid, he was one of the faithful companions of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. He participated in so many battles in defense of the religion of Islam and the words of Allah. He continued the battle even when the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, passed away and Abu Bakr came into the authority. He participated over 100 battles. His first participation in the battle for Islam was during the Battle of Mu'ta. Now listen to this. At that time, at the first participation, he was only 3 months old in Islam. He converted to Islam. After 3 months, there was a battle for Muslims to go. Look at you and me. You were born in Islam. You have lived in Islam. Many of us are in our 40s. Some are in their 50s. Others are in their 30s. What specifically have you done for this religion? What have you done for Islam? Ask yourself. And remember, prepare yourself because you will be asked.
خالد يخبر عن نفسه يوم معركة مؤتة قائلا رأس المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم 3 رؤساء لغزوة مؤتة فقال يرأس الجيش زيد بن ثابت فإن أصيب أي يعني قتل فجعفر الطيار فإن أصيب يعني إن قتل فعبد الله بن رواحة فلما كان يوم مؤتة في بلدة أردن في جوردن قتل هؤلاء الرؤساء 3 فأصبح المسلمون بلا رئيس فأصبح علم الإسلام تحت فأول من وصل إلى علم الإسلام ورفعها هو ثابت بن الأقرن لما رفعها رأى خالدا من بعيد ثم مشى بهذا العلم فقال لخالد خذها يا خالد. فقال خالد خذها أنت يا ثابت، فأنت من أهل بدر. أنا ما كنت مسلما إلا 3 أيام، إلا 3 أشهر، فماذا أقول في هذا؟ لا أعرف عن أحكام المعركة في إسلام شيء. فقال له ثابت إن هذا المكان ليس مكان الجدل، إن الدين يرأسها من يعلمها، إن الدين يرأسها من يريدها، إن الدين يرأسها من يحبها، إن الدين يرأسها من وهبه الله بقدرة الذاكرة، فخذها يا خالد فإنها لك. قال خالد فلم يكن لي ملجأ فأخذت هذا الراية. لما أخذته كان الرسول في المدينة فكبر الرسول 3 مرات، الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أخذ الراية سيف من سيوف الله المسلول.
For the slayers of Allah, when the Holy Prophet, peace be unto him, prepared his army to face the enemy in the battle of Mu'tah, he gave assignment to 3 of his companions to be the leaders. One of them was Zaid, Ja'far, and Abdullah. He said, when Zaid is injured or killed, Ja'far, then you should take over. And if anything should happen to Ja'far, Abdullah, you the next man in command. Now, he arranged it that way. As Allah could make it, all of the 3 leaders played their role and they were all killed by the enemy during this difficult battle. The one who saw the Muslim flag was thrown on the ground. And he rushed, and when he grabbed the flag, he looked in far distance. He saw Khalid. Mas'ad, when he saw Khalid, he ran to Khalid. He said, Khalid, hold the flag. Take lead. Be in charge. Now listen to the response of Khalid. Khalid said, no, you deserve this flag. You deserve this order. You deserve this assignment. Why? I am just a new Muslim. I'm just 3 months old in this religion. I do not know the rules and regulation of Islamic combat and battle. You take it. Now listen to the response by a God-fearing person. He said to him, no, this is not a place for position or honor to be given to someone who has been in this religion longer than you. The leadership, the assignment, you are entitled to this. The leadership of this religion, the assignment of this religion, the management of this religion belong to the one who loves Allah, belong to the one who fears Allah, belong to the one who is sincere, who has committed, but not to say, I started it, I begin it, I've been here longer. That is not a criteria of leadership. That is not a criteria of qualification. Commitment, sincerity, and believing in Allah at the same time to be available. So therefore, Khalid, take the leadership. When he held on to the flag, Allah showed a vision to the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, while he is in Medina among his companions. And he sounded the takbirat 3 times. He said, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, and Allahu Akbar. Now, Khalid has now taken the leadership of the Islamic army.
Abdullah, tasawwar jayshun adaduhum 3,000. يقابلون جيوشا عددهم 200,000 شخصا مقاتلا وكلهم مجهزون. وتصور جيوشا مشوا 600 ميل ذاهبين إلى هذا البلد ليغزوا هؤلاء الكفرة. وصلوا مع المشية مباشرة المعركة وقعت. يصف لنا الخالد الموقف. قال خالد أخذت الراية يوم مؤتة فكنت أبعث مسلمين، والله ما رأيت مسلما إلا وقد أحاطت به الكفرة 10 من الكفار. فقلت بمن أغزو مباشرة؟ فمشيت في الجيوش حتى قطعتها مرتين فجئت مرة وثلاث مرات وهذا الراية بيدي. فلما رأى المسلمون رايتهم يتجول في حساء المعركة كل بدأ يتجمع تحت هذه الراية. فقال خالد وهو يصف لنا هذا الموقف: والله وألف والله إن دك من يدي أسياف أكثر من تسعة أسياف، أي سيف تسعة قد كسر وحدها تلو الآخر في يدي يوم مؤتة. هذا ما وقع لخالد.
Fellow slaves of Allah, listen to the narration of Khalid. And firstly, let's look at the size and the number of the Islamic army during this battle. There were just 3,000 men. They walked long distance, about 600 miles to the battlefield. The moment they arrived at the battlefield, they engage into battle with the enemy. Now that tells you how difficult this battle was for the Muslim. He said the number of the enemy were almost about 200,000 men versus 3,000 men. The enemy were prepared for this battle. Khalid said, when he held on to the flag, he said, I look around to identify my brother Muslim, but for every one Muslim army, they were being surrounded by 10 or 20 of the enemy. So I ran through the crowd 2-3 times to make way with the flag above my head. When the Muslim army saw the flag in the hands of Khalid, they grew energy and strength and they began to gather themselves in one location to prepare to fight the enemy. Khalid said, he swore by Allah, during this battle, the sword that he used to fight against the enemy and were broken into pieces were about 9 swords. He uses that to kill the enemy. In the end, they were all destroyed and broken.
عباد الله، ماذا كان خالد يريد؟ ما أراد شيئا إلا كلمة واحدة في كتاب الله: إن تنصروا الله ينصركم. كان خالد يريد أن ينصر الله وينصر دين الله، ويعلم أنه سيلاقي ربه إن نصر دينه ينصره الله يوم أن يلقاه.
Fellow slaves of Allah, what exactly was Khalid looking for? What exactly was the objective of Khalid? The answer here is, Khalid only remember one verse from the Almighty Allah in the Holy Quran, in which he said, if you help and support the cause of Allah sincerely, Allah will support you and Allah will reward you. And what is that? Khalid had the firm belief, the firm understanding that one day he will leave this world, that one day he will pass, and no matter how long he lived, he will surely meet his Lord, which is Allah, and he will be asked, how did you spend your life during your lifetime? Khalid had a firm belief and understanding. That is the reason why he engaged in this effort sincerely and tirelessly.
Abdullah, فإذا كان هذا غرض خالد وقصده، إذن فما بالك أنت؟ أم حسبتم أن تدخلوا الجنة ولما يأتكم مثل الذين خلوا من قبلكم مستهم البأساء والضراء وزلزلوا حتى يقول الرسول والذين آمنوا معه متى نصر الله؟ زلزل المصطفى، عذب المصطفى، لماذا؟ بسبب جنة الرحمن. إذا كانوا قد ذاقوا سوء العذاب بسبب نصرة هذه الدين وبسبب إرضاء الله، إذن فما الذي أنت تنتظر وبأي شيء تدخل جنة الرحمن يا عبد الله.
Fellow slaves of Allah, now, do you think that you want to enter the paradise of Allah with ease? When you are told the story of those pious Muslims before you, the difficulty, the struggle that they went through only for the sake of Allah, and this was tested by the Almighty Allah. They lived to see so many difficulties, to the point the messengers of Allah, peace be on him, he said, "Oh Allah, you have assured us, you promised us, that you will help us, you will support us. But when will this help and support come to us?" Now you can see and understand the limit of difficulty they reach. The question is now, what have you done and what do you have that you think that will make you to enter paradise? Because we live by difficulty. Many of us come to the mosque only on Friday in our best attire. The regular day is off. When they say give for the sake of Allah, then we just wrap $2 and place it in a bag. And we know what happened. What makes you think you're going to go to heaven when you have not done anything? Now you ask yourself that.
Abdullah, بأي نتيجة حتى الآن تدخل الجنة؟ لأن بفوز النتيجة تجد جنة الرحمن. أبي النفاق تدخل جنة الرحمن؟
Oh, my brothers and sisters, what result or strategy have you designed that will make you eligible, that will make you qualified to enter into the paradise of Allah? Now, you're going to use deception and hypocrisy that is built in us, that is our culture, that what you depend on, you think that are going to make you to go to the paradise? Bad news.
أبي الرياء تدخل جنة الرحمن.
Now, to show off and impress people that you are a good and pious Muslim, now that's why you're going to depend on your thing, because you come to Friday prayer once a month or twice a month, that will take you to paradise. Bad news.
أبي العجب والكبر تدخل جنة الرحمن.
Pomposity and arrogance that is in us, you think that's what's going to put you into the paradise of Allah, to be in the neighborhood of Allah? Bad news.
أبي الفاحشة تدخل جنة الرحمن.
Well, wrongdoing and mischief that we are engaged into on a daily basis, your love for doing bad things, your love for being in bad company, your love to have bad friends and do what they do, you think that is the one that's going to take you to paradise? No.
أبي صلاتك الصلوات الخمسة في بيتك وفي عملك أو في سيارتك به تجد جنة الرحمن.
Well, are you impressed with your 5 daily prayer, which sometimes you pray in your car while you're driving, or you pray in your house? You don't even have the time to come to the masjid. You think that prayer, that is the one that's going to qualify you to enter into paradise? No.
أبي سماعك الأغاني ورؤية الأفلام الماجنة أبيه تدخل جنة الرحمن.
Well, your useless time, meaning the time you spend uselessly listening to music of different kind, watching movies that are not of any benefit for you, you don't read the Quran, you don't listen to the Quran, you don't make effort to learn the Quran, and even if you know, you don't teach other people the Quran, sometimes it slips away from you. Now, you think that is the one that's going to qualify you to go to paradise? No.
أبي ضياع أمانة جماعتك وضياعة مسجدك وضياعة إسلامك الأمان الذي عهدت الله ألا أن تعتكف عليه بضياع هذه الأمانة أبيه تدخل جنة الرحمن.
Your betrayal of confidence and trust from your friend, from your family, from your community, even in your masjid. They trust you and gave you position because they feel you know something. Lead us, guide us. You betrayed our confidence. You betrayed our trust. They gave you something to hold. You must use it. Now, you take pride of that. You let down your community. You let down people who look to you as model, people who look to you as leader. You must use the confidence and trust. Now, you think that's going to take you to heaven? No.
أَبِاتِّخَاذِكَ الدِّينِ لَعِبًا وَاتِّخَاذِ اللَّعِبَ دِينًا إِنْ قِيلَ هُنَاكَ عَقِيقَ أَوِ التَّسْمِيَةَ كُنْتَ هُنَاكَ إِنْ قِيلَ هُنَاكَ النِّكَاحَ كُنْتَ هُنَاكَ إِنْ قِيلَ هُنَاكَ جَنَازَةَ كُنْتَ هُنَاكَ أَمَّا إِذَا جَاءَ الدِّينِ فَلَسْتَ هُنَاكَ أَبِهَذَا تَجْرِي جَنَّةِ الرَّحْمَنِ.
My brothers and sisters, your neglect for act towards this religion, when you are told to come and perform with a Muslim in a mosque, you don't have time. But you use this religion by your own definition as play and sport. How? Whenever you hear that there's going to be a baby Nimi, you are the first on the clock. When you hear that there is a funeral prayer, you are there. When you hear there is a merrymaking, you are the first. When you hear there is occasion, you are in the middle to be recognized. But when it comes to the actual function or duty of you as Muslim to come and pray in a masjid, do what is right, you don't have time. Now, because of those things, you think that is enough and sufficient to pull you into the heaven of Allah? No.
عباد الله إن جنة الرحمن يوجد بشيء واحدا ألا وهو المجاهدة والذين جاهدوا فينا لنهدينهم سبلنا وإن الله لمع المحسنين. إذا جاهدت في دينك مجاهدة حقيقية لقيامك لصلاة الفجر، مجاهدة حقيقية لقيامك لصلاة العشاء، مجاهدة حقيقية بلطفك مع زوجتك، مجاهدة حقيقية مع الآخرين، مجاهدة حقيقية مع هذا الدين، أقسم الله أنه سيهديك الطريق إليه. أما إن لم يكن معك هذا المجاهدة فشتان بينك وبين الله، وشتان بينك وبين جنة الرحمن، فإنك اقتربت نفسك إلى نار جهنم وسينهرك الله فيها. نعوذ بالله من هذا.
Fellow slaves of Allah, in order to be in the neighborhood of the Almighty Allah, which is in a paradise, there's one way, there's one method. And what is that? Is the sincere effort, the sincere strive for the sake of Allah. Now, how do we support this? Allah said in the Quran that those men and women, meaning believing men and believing women, who strive, who make effort sincerely for the sake of Allah, Allah say, I will guide them, I will protect them on the path that I've recommended. And that path is the one that's going to lead you into the entering of paradise. Now, bear in mind, the sincere effort during your interaction with your friends, you have to be sincere. Your affection, sincere affection to your wife and children, to your husband and children, is necessary. Sincerity in all of your undertaking and deeds, that is the one that going to qualify you to be in the neighborhood of Allah, which is Al-Jannah. Otherwise than that, if you choose another way, another method, as many of us here now we do, now have in mind, you are far away from the entrance into paradise. You have a distance from the entrance into paradise. You fail the criteria. You are disqualified. You know where you're going to go? It's the hellfire. May Allah protect us against that.
أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
You've heard what has been said. I ask Allah's forgiveness for myself and all of the Muslims, and I ask you to ask Allah forgiveness.
Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, Azim al-Minnah, wa Nasir al-Din bi Ahl al-Sunnah, نحمده وفقنا إلى الهدى حمدا كثيرا ليس يحصى عدد وبعد حمد الله إني أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله مستحقا يعبد إلا الإله الواحد الفرد السمد.
Praise and thanks I do unto Allah, Allah who has bestowed upon all His mercy and greatness as human being. It is Allah who has provided support to believing men and women in the discharge of their religious responsibility. Certainly, Allah deserves to be thanked and praised, and Allah deserves to be worshipped, because there's no God except the Almighty Allah. He is alone and has no associate.
عباد الله الثبات في دين الله نعيم ونعمة ولكن لا يدرك بالنعيم أي لا يوجد بالنعيم.
Fellow slaves of Allah, in order to attain piety, in order to attain the mercy of Allah in this religion, to be rewarded with paradise, bear in mind, it is blessing and endowment from the Almighty Allah. But the method to achieve so can never be undermined.
تبلغ دين الله سبحانه وتعالى إلى الخلق وعدم الفساد في الأرض نعيم ولكن لا يوجد بالنعيم إنما يوجد بالتعب والمشقة.
Fellow slaves of Allah, the propagation of the religion of Islam to others, the extension of the message of the Holy Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, is indeed honorable and blessing. But you can never achieve that with ease. You have to go through a difficult slope. You have to go through tireless effort. You have to see those difficulties. In the end, then you can see, you can reward the, you can get the, you can reap the reward and the benefit from the Almighty Allah.
Abdullah, nasihati ila al-muslimin wa ila shababiha. Ya musir al-muslimin wa du'at al-islam ومن هم قادة للإسلام والمسلمين والله إن هذا الدين بدايتها ونهايتها معركة كل ما ستفعله فيه إن لم يضحكك قومك أهلك سيضحكونك إن لم يضحكك أهلك الكفار حواليك سيضحكونك إذن فجاهدوا فيها وتمسكوا بها فبهذا تجدون رضا الله سبحانه وتعالى أما سلاح هذا الجهاد هو المال الذي رزقكم الله إياها إن أخرجتم هذا الأموال وسلمتموها لله ولدين الله أدركتم ما عند الله سبحانه وتعالى.
Fellow slaves of Allah, I am giving you my candid advice to the Muslim community, to the young generation, to the youth, specifically those of our scholars, the learned people in this religion, listen to this advice. Those of you who are our community leaders, listen to this advice. Those of you whom Allah has placed in honor and position, that you are opinion leaders, listen to this advice. Young men and women, listen to this advice. This religion we find ourselves in, we have to make effort. We have to make tireless effort. You should understand, in order to become a believing man and woman, you are going to be challenged by difficulty. So you will be engaged into battle. And what is this battle? When you take it seriously, when you commit yourself to this religion, you will find other people who will make mockery out of you. If they don't make mockery of you, your own relative and family will make mockery of you. They will laugh at you. They will call you name. All of these are tests. Bear in mind, you are not doing it to impress anyone. You are doing it wholly and solely for the Almighty Allah. So wholly with your strength, maintain the dignity and the integrity of this religion of Islam as it has been commanded by the Almighty Allah.
عباد الله نهاية كلام يكون كالشمس إذا غربت في جهة أشرقت في جهة أخرى إذن هي لا تزال مضيئة متلألئة لمنفعة البشر فكونوا كذلك أينما وجدتم كونوا أصحاب خير لا ترضون لأنفسكم أن تكونوا أصحاب شر فإن الدين لأهل الخير لا لأهل الشر.
Fellow slaves of Allah, the weapon you have that will prepare you to face challenges and this battle we talk about is the money that Allah has placed in your means. I'm advising you, my brothers and sisters in Islam, to serve like a sun. When the sun is shining in one part of the world, it's dark in other part. When the night comes, the daylight will be transferred to other. The sun giving us benefit under the services of Allah all year round. Wherever you are, be in the company of good people and do good things. This religion belongs to people who think good, who live good, and who behave good. This religion is far away from people who do wrong things and take pride of it and be supported by others who also engage into similar things. This religion does not belong to you. Remember that.
Abdullah, nihayatuha haza dinu ukhuwa. Inna akhakum Muhammad Mukhtar. هو معنا منذ شهور عديدة فقدناه في المسجد أتدرون لماذا؟ هل سألتم عن شأنه؟ إنه لا زال ولن يزال مع الأطباء ليل نهار لماذا؟ لأن الكلية بتاعه تعبان الآن يراد منكم من يتبرع منه بكلية فإن فعلت فكأنك أحييت الناس جميعا إن فعلتم أنتم كأهل هذا المسجد كان لكم درجة عند الله فإن لم تفعلوها فهذا آخر خطبتي إليكم وإني سأسألكم على الخط إن فعلتم فهلا وإن لم تفعلوا سنرسل من سيقوم بهذا وهو هناك في قارة إفريقيا بإذن الله.
Fellow slaves of Allah, remember, this religion of Islam is based on brotherhood. One of our brother, Mukhtar, has been absent from this masjid for a little while ago. But have you asked yourself, why is it I'm not seeing my brother on Friday? He is not well. He is ill. He's taking treatment. And it has been discovered that he suffers from a disease. A disease in which is curable. But in order to cure this disease, there has to be a volunteer who will volunteer to support. And that is kidney disease. I am asking you to make it your business and volunteer. But whether you do it or not, today is my last sermon to you. I will be traveling to Africa. But I will tell you, if you fail as community and mosque to do it, I will go back home and by Allah's grace, we will find somebody in Africa and send that person to come and help our brother. Because when you help your brother under these difficult circumstances, it means you have supported life. That is the objective.
عباد الله فأقول لكم نهايتها بسبب هذا المريض وبسبب مرض هذا المسجد لو أمطر يعود في المسجد أنا أنهيكم وأقول للجميع على الكل أن يتبرع أقل شيء لا ترضى أن تخرج من المسجد إلا وقد برأت أكثر من $10 إعانة لمسجد وإعانة لهذا العبد وجماعته.
Fellow slaves of Allah, as I conclude my sermon, I want to leave you with just this. Due to the illness of our brother and the illness of the masjid, because whenever it rains, the water back up in the basement, our children have not been able to attend classes now for 3 weeks. It has to be repaired, and this may cost about $7,000 or $7,500. I'm asking all of you not to leave the masjid today unless you make a sincere contribution, not less than $10, for our brother as well as for the difficulty that we have faced by, for the sake of Allah.
Abdullah, فأنا أريد أن أرى الأيادي 20 لا أخذها الآن. من سيتبرع $100 20 شخصا ثم نصلي وبعد الصلاة نأخذها.
Before we commence a prayer, I'm not asking you now. I'm asking you, the man. I want 20 volunteers that will pledge or give $100 for this cause. And after Salat, we will collect it. Or we'll take that name. Then after that, we continue.
من منكم أنا أريد الأيدي من يريد جنة الرحمن ويعين أخاه في الله ربنا أيضا سيعينه كما تدين تدان يوم له ويوم عليك.
I just want to see the finger in the air. Who will be among the 20?
Allahu Akbar.
Raise your hand.
Allahu Akbar.
And remember, when you give,
Allahu Akbar,
you will be given. You
Allahu
have today. Akbar. Today is one person, tomorrow it could be you. Who knows?
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
فإنني رأيت أكثر من عشرة.
I saw Allahu more than Akbar. 10 hands.
وأريد من النسوة أيضا كذلك عشرة. من سيتبرعن بعد الصلاة.
The women, we are not looking at you, but we want you to volunteer. At least 10 women. And after the prayer, we shall make the collection.
وَأَمَّا الَّذِي مَا تَدَاخَلَ فِي $100 أَسْأَلُكَ بِاللَّهِ وَبِجَنَّةِ الَّذِي تُرِيدُهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَلَّا تَتْرُكَ مَسْجِدَنَا الْيَوْمِ إِلَّا وَقَدْ تَبَرَّأْتَ أَكْثَرَ مِنْ $10.
Those of you who could not raise your hand because of situation, Allah knows best, but I'm telling you, do not leave this masjid unless you make a contribution, not less than $10 before you leave. This is my advice to you.
اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا اللهم ربنا يسر لنا ولا تعسر علينا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين اللهم ربنا اغفر لجميع مرضى المسلمين اللهم ربنا اغفر لجميع مرضى المسلمين الذين شهدوا لك بالوحدانية ولنبيك بالرسالة وماتوا على ذلك اللهم ربنا اغفر لهم وارحمهم وعافهم واعف عنهم اللهم ربنا نقهم من الذنوب والخطايا كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس اللهم ربنا اغفر لجميع موتانا اللهم ربنا من كان مسيئا فتجاوز عن سيئاته ومن كان محسنا فزد في إحسانه بالأمس القريب شيعنا بنتا من أبناء المسلمين ربنا نسألك أن تغفر لها وترحمها اللهم ربنا يسر ولا تعسر أبلغت أن الصلاة أيضا صلي على أحد المسلمين أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يغفر لجميعهم اللهم ربنا اغفر لهم وارحمهم اللهم ربنا اجعل أعمالنا خالصة لوجهك لا رياء اللهم ربنا ارفع مال المسلمين من بلاء وشدة. اللهم ربنا يسر لجميع موتى المسلمين. اللهم ربنا إنا نسألك الخير واليسر في الدنيا والآخرة. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. اللهم ربنا كل من أنفق فيك اللهم فأنفق فيه. اللهم كل من أنفق فيك فأنفق فيه. اللهم ربنا يسر ولا تعسر. اللهم ربنا أسألك كل من تصدق بصدقة أن ترزقه في الدنيا وأن ترزقه في الآخرة وأن تجعله من المحبين إليك يوم القيامة. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. تذكروا عباد الله إن وفيتم عهود الله وفى الله عهودكم. أوفوا بعهدي أوف بعهدكم وإياي فارهبون.